செலீனியம், செலீனியம்ஸ், டூல் சூட், செலீனியம்ஸ் டூல் சூட் ஆர் செலீனியம் காம்போனன்ட்ஸ், செலீனியம் காம்போனன்ட்ஸ். சி, ஐ வில் கிவ் பிரீஃப் இன்ட்ரடக்ஷன். இன் ஃபியூச்சர் சாப்டர்ஸ் வி வில் டிஸ்கஸ் ஈச் அண்ட் எவ்ரி கான்செப்ட் இன் டீடைல்டு மேனர். சி, ஹியர் வி ஹாவ் ஃபோர் காம்போனன்ட்ஸ் ஆர் டூல்ஸ். ஒன் இஸ் செலீனியம் ஐடிஇ, செலீனியம் ஐடிஇ. ஐடிஇ ஸ்டாண்ட்ஸ் ஃபார் இன்டிகிரேட்டட் டெவலப்மெண்ட் என்விரான்மெண்ட். நெக்ஸ்ட், செலீனியம் ஆர்சி, ஆர்சி. ஸ்மிதா, ஆர்சி ஸ்டாண்ட்ஸ் ஃபார்
ரிமோட் கண்ட்ரோல்.
குட், ரிமோட் கண்ட்ரோல். ஓகே, நெக்ஸ்ட், செலீனியம் வெப் டிரைவர், வெப் டிரைவர். பவர்ஃபுல் டூல் இன் திஸ் சூட். நெக்ஸ்ட், செலீனியம் கிரிட், செலீனியம் கிரிட். சி, தீஸ் ஆர் த செலீனியம் டூல்ஸ் ஆர் செலீனியம் காம்போனன்ட்ஸ். ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஐ எம் டேக்கிங் செலீனியம் ஐடிஇ, செலீனியம் ஐடிஇ. ஹேவ் எனி ஐடியா சஞ்சீதா, செலீனியம் ஐடிஇ, வாட் இஸ் செலீனியம் ஐடிஇ?
செலீனியம் ஐடிஇ இஸ் மோடுலர் ஃபயர் ஃபார்ம் ஆட்
ஆன். ஆ,
and is just only for record and playback.
Okay, good, good. See, it is a Firefox browser add-on. It is a Firefox browser add-on used to create and execute test cases. Used to create and execute test cases. Say, in manual testing, a term is test case. In Selenium also, same term, test case. Or you can use test script, test case, or test script. Both are synonyms. But in EFT, formerly QTP, no test case term. Test, test or test script. But in Selenium, official term is test case, or you can use test script. Both are same. See, it is a Firefox browser add-on used to create and execute test cases. Next, Selenium IDE features. Selenium IDE features. Create test cases and test suits. Suits means test batch. Create test cases one by one. And test suits. Suit means batch. See, for creating test cases in Selenium IDE, we can follow two ways, either recording or you can type test script manually. See, in two ways we can generate test cases in Selenium IDE. Anyhow, It is only theoretical approach, brief introduction. In Selenium IDE chapter, we will discuss each and every concept in detailed manner with the examples, practical examples. See, in two ways we can create and we can create test cases in Selenium IDE. What are the two ways? One is recording, another is typing test steps manually. If you know the syntax, see, we can record test cases, record user actions on AUT. We can record test cases or type test steps using element locators. Element means object. For example, button, link, radio button, checkbox, combo box, drop down box, etc. Using element locators and Selenus commands. Selenium IDE commands are called as Selenus commands, or you can say Selenium IDE commands. If you know the syntax, you can type test steps. Otherwise, you can use recording feature. Then if you use recording feature, it will generate test steps automatically. Otherwise, you can type the test steps. Next, edit test cases. Edit, just a minute. Edit test cases. See, we can edit existing test cases. Whenever we want to modify the test cases, we can modify. Next, execute test cases. Playback. Execute test cases. Next, test suites. Group of test cases at a time. At a time means it will execute continuously. Next, debug test cases. Debug test cases. What is debugging? Debugging is a development term. We use programming logic in our test cases, so that we need to familiar with this debug term. Debug means locating and isolating errors through step-by-step execution. Locating and isolating errors through step-by-step execution. Next, enhance test cases. Enhance test cases. What is enhancing test cases? Say, creating plain navigation, that is basic test case. Enhancing test case means inserting verification points, adding comments, etc. Enhancing test cases. Next, exporting test cases to other formats. Say, actually, Selenium IDE doesn't support programming logic. Selenium IDE doesn't support programming logic. Selenium WebDriver supports various programming languages. Selenium RC supports various programming languages. But Selenium IDE doesn't support programming logic. But Selenium IDE test case default format is HTML, but we can export test cases to other formats. See, but this feature is not working fine. Anyhow, we don't use Selenium IDE in our companies. It is also slowly getting outdated. But for intermediate purpose, for identifying the objects, we can use Selenium IDE. But nowadays, most of the companies using Selenium WebDriver only. See, export test cases to other formats, other supporting formats, other formats. What are the other supporting formats? Java, Ruby, etc. Next, what is the default format, Niladri Chowdhury? What is the default format of Selenium IDE test case?
HTML.
HTML, good. See, Selenium IDE default Selenium IDE test case. Selenium IDE test case default format is HTML. Say, Selenium IDE test case syntax is different from Selenium WebDriver test case syntax. See, next, drawbacks of Selenium IDE. Can you identify one or two drawbacks of Selenium IDE, Sunil? Drawbacks of Selenium IDE. Identify one or two drawbacks. Smita, identify one or two drawbacks of Selenium IDE.
It supports only Mozilla Firefox browser.
Yes, it supports only Mozilla Firefox. Next.
Doesn't support logic features, programming
yes, it
logic.
It doesn't support programming logic to enhance test cases. Okay. Yes. See, first one. It supports Mozilla Firefox browser only. It supports Mozilla Firefox browser only. Next. It doesn't support programming features. It doesn't support programming logic or pro features to enhance test cases. All of you put mute after answering the question. Put mute test cases. See, we cannot use conditional statements, loop statements, and other programming features like variables, operators, methods, etc. Next, it doesn't support data driven testing. For data driven testing, what is data driven testing? Executing same test cases with multiple sets of test data. It doesn't support data-driven testing. It doesn't support. See, somebody is making noise. Avoid that one. I think Gurnath put mute. And Sanjeeda also. Whenever you want to ask any question, and again, Whenever you want to ask any question, unmute it and again put mute. Sanjida, put mute.
Yes. I'm in phone. I don't know.
Okay, cool. Okay, cool. Leave it. Leave it. But avoid the disturbance. See, it doesn't support data-driven testing. Data-driven testing. For data-driven testing, resource is required. What is resource in this scenario? Suppose test data file is resource. For data-driven testing, resource is required. So, data-driven testing is not possible in Selenium IDE. Next, it is not suitable for complex test case design. It is just a prototyping tool. It is just a prototyping tool. It is not suitable for complex test case design. Only for simple test cases. Only for designing simple test cases. See, it is not suitable for complex test case design. Why? Niladri, why it is not suitable for complex test case design?
Because we cannot do, we cannot apply any programming logics
yes.
for there.
Here, no programming support. So, not suitable for complex test case design. It is just a prototyping tool, only for simple test cases. Next, one more drawback. No centralized maintenance of elements. No centralized. If it is UFT, formerly QTP, in UFT, object repository concept is there. Using object repository feature, you can maintain objects in centralized location in UFT tool. But in Selenium IDE, no centralized maintenance of objects or elements. No centralized maintenance. Of elements or objects. What are elements, Sanjida? Web elements. Give some examples.
Yes.
Web elements.
Like link, radio button,
yes.
edit box.
Yes. Say functional test automation tools. Not only Selenium, you take UFT, RFT, any functional and test, functional and regression test automation tool. They are object-based tools. Based on front-end objects, they perform test operations.
Can I ask a question?
Yes.
Yes. What is the difference functional testing and regression testing?
See, that is part that we will discuss later.
Functional. Okay, sure.
See, regression testing, one of the type in functional testing, in regression also, we conduct functional only. Getting this point? Otherwise, you can say just a functional test tool, functional test tool, performance test tool, etc. Different tools. But why I'm classifying functional and regression? Regression is some different scenario, but in regression testing also, we conduct functional testing only. Getting this point?
Yes.
No centralized maintenance of elements. See, these are the important drawbacks of Selenium IDE. Can you tell me, Gurnath? Selenium IDE features. Features.
IDE features.
Tell me what are the important features.
Like it is a Firefox browser add-on. And like then it is able to select the element locators, and Selenium commands are used for this one.
And less clarity or no clarity. See, creating test cases and test suits, for that we can use either recording feature or type test script using element locators and Selenus commands. Maintain clarity.
So creating test cases and test suits. And third one is editing the test cases. And we can debug the test cases. And we can execute the test cases and suite of them. And then it is in the format of HTML, but it can be, it supports Firefox.
It supports other formats for exporting test cases. Example, Java,
like Ruby. Java, Ruby, etc.
Okay, cool. Next, Sunil. Drawbacks of Selenium IDE, Sunil.
Yeah, it supports only the Firefox browser. And it does not support the programming logic, and also it does not support the data-driven testing. You cannot perform data-driven testing. Also, it's not suitable for the complex text case design. And there is no maintenance, centralized maintenance of elements or objects.
Good. Yeah. See. Okay, now Sanjita, shall we move to next component?
Yes, sir.
See.
Next component. I have one question, sir.
Yes,
actually, I just want to understand what is the difference between test case and test suite here?
Test?
In Selenium.
Pardon?
Difference between test case and test suite.
See, very simple. What is test suite? Group of test cases, or set of test cases, or bunch of test cases.
Okay.
Suppose you created 10 test cases. If you form the group, that is test suite. Suite.
Yeah, got it.
Means test batch. See, synonyms. Test batches, or you can say test sets, etc. Say, but Selenium official term is test suite. You can use test batch term, test set, group of test cases. Say,
okay,
or you can say series of test cases. Okay, say. Test automation, advantage of test automation is, one of the advantage of test automation is batch testing. You can group test cases and execute test batches. You can group test cases and execute test batches without human user interaction. If it is manual testing, for each and every test case execution, human user interaction is mandatory. Okay?
Yes. Okay. Yes, got it. Thank you, sir.
Welcome. See, next. Selenium RC, remote control. It is outdated. Actually, in order to overcome the limitations of Selenium IDE, Selenium RC launched. Selenium, you no need to learn Selenium RC. Nowadays it is outdated. Just remember, Selenium RC supports various programming languages to write test scripts. Next, Selenium RC supports various browsers for creating and executing test cases. But Selenium RC tool is slower in execution. In order to overcome some limitations of Selenium RC, Selenium WebDriver was launched. See, Selenium RC outdated. You no need to learn Selenium RC. Nowadays, some companies only using Selenium RC for maintenance projects, not for new projects. Next, Selenium WebDriver. Selenium. What are the important features of Selenium RC? Important features of Selenium RC, Smita?
Is used for
maintenance projects. That is different. That is not feature. That is usage. It supports various browsers, na?
Yeah, it supports various browsers
and various programming languages, Java, C Sharp, Perl, Python, Ruby, etc. for creating test scripts. Okay, na?
Okay.
Selenium WebDriver. See, powerful tool in this suit. Using Selenium WebDriver only, you can automate your entire project. See, what is Selenium WebDriver? See, it is a programming interface to create and execute test cases. Remember this point. It is a programming interface. See, avoid the disturbance. Sanjida, avoid the disturbance, Sanjida. You don't type anything. I will send the notes. See, remaining all people in mute. You are not able to put mute now. So avoid the disturbance. See. It is a programming interface to create and execute test cases. To create and execute test cases. Say, it doesn't have IDE. No IDE, Integrated Development Environment, means no menus. No menu items. For each and everything, you need to write the code. If you want to identify the element, write the code. And perform operation on element, write the code. If it is Selenium IDE, IDE has menus and menu items. Suppose recording feature is there. Using recording feature, you can generate test steps. You can generate test steps for user actions on AUT. Execute, run feature is there, you can run. Next, you can form test suite. Say Selenium IDE has menus and menu items, but Selenium WebDriver doesn't have IDE. Here no menus, no menu items. For each and every task, we need to write the code. It provides editor only. No menus. For example, UFT, formerly QTP. UFT has both IDE as well as programming interface. For example, if you want to create test case or test in UFT, if you want to create tests in UFT, for that you can use recording feature, that is IDE, recording feature, or you can type test script in UFT tool editor. Suppose if you want to insert verification points, for that you can use UFT tool feature, checkpoints, otherwise VB script features, conditional statements. See, UFT supports VB script only for applying programming logic. But Selenium supports various programming languages. But UFT, formerly QTP, supports VB script only. See, if you want to create test cases in UFT, you can use either tool features or script features or both. some tool features and some script features. But in Selenium WebDriver, tell me, Neeladri, in Selenium WebDriver?
In Selenium WebDriver, we can use only the
only the programming interface, no tool features here, isn't it?
Yeah.
No yes, recording feature, no recording feature, no checkpoints, no integrated yeah. data table, etc.
Yes.
See, just a brief idea, general topic. See, for example, Selenium IDE. Selenium IDE has integrated development environment, but no programming interface. No programming interface. We can type test steps using commands, Selenus commands. No programming logic. See, Selenium IDE has IDE only, integrated development environment only, but no programming interface. Next, Selenium WebDriver. Selenium WebDriver. WebDriver has programming interface only. Programming interface only. But no IDE. Next, for example, UFT, formerly QTP. QTP has both IDE and programming interface. Interface. Say Selenium WebDriver is faster in execution than other tools in Selenium suite. Not only in Selenium suite. Selenium WebDriver is faster than UFT also. Why? It has only programming interface, no tool features, no burden on tool, no burden on tool. Suppose UFT, if you use checkpoint for verification point, some burden on tool. If you use programming feature, conditional statements, no burden on tool. See, programming features are faster in execution than tool features. So Selenium WebDriver is faster than other tools in Selenium suite. Not only other tools in Selenium suite, also UFT, RFT, etc. And one more thing, if it is only programming interface, some difficult to create test cases. Takes time. Some difficulty is there, but you can do anything and faster in execution. Okay. Selenium WebDriver has only programming interface. No IDE. Okay na, Sanjida?
Yeah.
Okay. Next, already we discussed Selenium WebDriver. Selenium WebDriver supports various programming languages. Various programming languages. to write programs. To write programs. Whereas Selenium IDE, Gurnath, what about Selenium IDE?
It does not.
Selenium IDE doesn't support programming.
Yes, sir. Programming logic, it doesn't support.
Doesn't support. Here it supports various programming languages. What are the programming languages?
Java, Ruby.
Java, C sharp.
C sharp. Python.
Python.
Ruby.
Ruby.
Perl, PHP.
Perl and PHP. PHP. Okay. Next, you know, Selenium WebDriver supports various browsers. Already we discussed Selenium WebDriver supports various browsers. Preeti, what are the five industry popular browsers? Preeti.
Firefox browser.
Firefox.
Then Chrome.
Chrome.
IE.
Just a minute. IE. Mozilla Firefox. Google Chrome. Internet Explorer. Next.
Then Safari. Safari.
Safari.
Opera.
Opera. Okay. Etc. Safari, Opera, etc. And one more thing, test cases, same. How we create test cases in Selenium WebDriver? Using element locators and WebDriver methods, we create test cases. Say, using element locators, using element locators and WebDriver methods, or you can say WebDriver commands, using element locators and WebDriver methods or commands, we create test cases. We create test cases. How we create test cases in Selenium IDE, Smita? How we create test cases in Selenium IDE? If it is recording or manual test script, using
using element locators
and
WebDriver methods or commands.
What is my question? You continue
okay.
on. My question is,
maybe,
how we create test cases in Selenium IDE?
Using UI element locators and methods.
What are methods? If it is no programming, no method concept. Method is equivalent term to function. You continue, Sunil. How we create test cases in Selenium IDE?
Menu and menu items.
No. Menu and menu items. Gurnath.
Using record. Using HTML.
Gurnath.
Yes, sir.
How we create test cases in Selenium IDE? Just for comparison, WebDriver versus. Already we discussed.
Yes, sir. Only IDE. Menus and yeah, only IDE we use, sir.
Using record and run feature as menu script.
Okay. Preeti Joshi.
Record and playback.
We can record the test cases.
Recording is one of the possibility for creating test cases. But what?
Yeah, and we can type that test cases.
Okay.
Using element locators and Selenus command.
Element locators and Selenus command.
Okay, yeah, we can use the record test case and
see, recording or you type test script directly.
Yes, sir.
Use recording or you type test steps. But
test steps.
But using element locators and Selenus commands only, Selenium IDE create and execute test cases. See,
okay.
Already we discussed the recording or type test script. But what are the prerequisites? See, just a minute. What I told. This point important. How we create test cases in Selenium IDE using recording or type test steps, but how using element locators and Selenus commands. See, if it is recording or you type test script, syntax same. If it is recording, tool can generate steps automatically. If you type, you need to type the same syntax. See, here important point is using element locators and Selenus commands, we create test cases in Selenium IDE. In Selenium WebDriver, Smita, in Selenium WebDriver, how we create test cases in Selenium WebDriver?
We need to write logic, programming interface.
Logic required for creating test cases. For enhancing test cases, logic required. Can you tell me, Sanjeeva? Pardon?
Element locator and web driver methods.
Yes, using element locators and web driver methods. Don't confuse, Smita. Using element locators and web driver methods, we can create test cases. Already I told, observe. Using element locators and web driver methods, we can create test cases. Here, what is the common concept? Aarti, common concept. Selenium IDE, Selenium WebDriver. Common thing.
Using element locators.
Element locators common, isn't it?
Yes.
But in Selenium IDE, we use Selenus commands. In Selenium WebDriver, we use WebDriver methods or commands for performing operations on elements. But element identification using element locators only, if it is Selenium IDE or WebDriver. Observe, element locators for identifying the elements. WebDriver methods for performing operations on elements. Suppose in Gmail homepage, Google link in Google homepage, Gmail link is there. Identifying this Gmail link, that is the responsibility of element locator. Next, I want to click this link. Click is operation. Clicking this link is responsibility of WebDriver method. Getting this point, Smita? What is the purpose of element locators? To identify or recognize elements. Next, what is the purpose of WebDriver methods or commands? Smita, say yes or no. What is the purpose of WebDriver methods and methods or commands?
Performing operations.
Performing on operations on elements.
On elements.
Elements. See, don't confuse. Performing operations on elements. Any confusion, Smita? Why you are not responding?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Suppose in Google homepage, Google homepage, suppose one of the element. Element is Gmail link. Element, one of the element is Gmail link. Identifying this Gmail link is the responsibility of element locator. What are the element locators and how to use that, we will discuss later. Next, click Gmail link. See, first observe, identify or recognize Gmail link in Google homepage. This is one task. Next, click on Gmail link. This is operation. Okay, now?
Yes, sir.
Suppose in Gmail homepage, Gmail home. Just a minute. This is Gmail home. This edit box is there. What is this edit box? Element. What is the primary operation on this element?
Click.
Click. You click edit box as?
User input.
Yes. User input. Enter a value into edit box. That is operation on that element. Next. Gurunath. Next button is there. What is the primary operation on next button?
It's a WebDriver method. It takes to the next page. Like, now, once you enter the password, like,
forget
now.
About WebDriver method. What is click. Manual operation? What is the primary operation on button?
Click.
Entering the username, like, no primary option.
Click.
Click.
Okay.
What is the primary operation on link?
Click.
Click. Yeah.
Click. What is the primary operation on radio button?
Select.
Select. What is the primary operation on checkbox?
Select.
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 What is the primary operation on drop down box?
Select.
Select. Select an item.
Yeah.
Select an item. Okay. Okay, now Sanjeeda, identifying the element and performing operation on that element.
Yes.
See, in this Selenium WebDriver, recognize or identifying element is the responsibility of element locator. Next, click or perform operation on that element. Perform operation on that element is the responsibility of WebDriver method or command. In Selenium IDE, identifying element, that is responsibility of element locator, performing operation on that element. In Selenium IDE, Sunil, performing operation on that element, performing operation on elements, responsibility of
I didn't understand the question, sir. Can you please come again?
Okay. Neeladri, all of you concentrate. Observe,
yes.
Neeladri, in Selenium WebDriver, identifying or recognizing elements is the responsibility of element locator.
Yes.
Next, performing operation on that element is the responsibility of WebDriver method or command. In
yes.
Selenium IDE, yes. Same, identifying or recognizing element using element locator only, but performing mm-hmm. operation on element
is Selenus command.
Yes, Selenus command. Selenus yeah. command. Okay. Okay, now Sanjida.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Say, using element locators and web driver methods or commands, we can create test cases. Here, we discussed Mozilla Fire. It supports various browsers. Supports various browsers. How it supports various browsers? Preeti Joshi, how it supports various browsers? Any difference in element locators? Any difference in WebDriver
no.
methods?
Yes.
No.
No.
It is just
element
we have
locators.
To install
element locators. Common. Element locators are common for all browsers. WebDriver methods are commands also common for all browsers. Then what is the difference?
We have to just install the driver.
Okay. Just a browser driver.
Yes.
See, browser driver only varies. See, browser driver. See, I will introduce browser drivers in cross browser testing chapter. Just remember this concept. Browser driver only varies from one browser to another. Browser to another. Okay, now Gurnath, element locators common. Web driver methods
yes,
or commands are common, but only difference
yes,
is browser driver. If it
yes,
is,
sir.
If you want to execute test case in Mozilla Firefox, then use Mozilla Firefox driver. If you want to
okay,
execute
sir.
Same test case using Chrome browser, use Chrome driver. If you want to execute same test case in Internet Explorer, then use
IE browser
driver. Okay, next, Selenium web driver supports Selenium web driver supports various programming various operating environments. Operating environments. What about Selenium IDE, Preeti, in case of supporting various program, various operating environments? Preeti, getting my question? What about Selenium
yes.
web driver supports various operating environments? What about Selenium IDE? Does it support or not?
It doesn't support.
No, supports. See, Selenium IDE supports only Mozilla Firefox browser. Okay. Selenium IDE doesn't support any programming logic. Okay. But Selenium IDE supports various programming various operating environments. See, you can install Mozilla on Linux na. You can install Mozilla on Windows na. You can install Mozilla on Macintosh na.
Yes, sir.
Observe, don't confuse. See, observe three points. Selenium WebDriver supports various browsers. Next, various programming languages to write programs. Next, various operating environments. Whereas Selenium IDE doesn't support various browsers, only Mozilla Firefox browser. Next, Selenium IDE doesn't support programming logic, but Selenium IDE supports various operating environments, isn't it? Respond, Smita. Did you understand this point? Understand the point?
Yes, sir.
Just a minute. Windows. Next, Unix flavor, Linux.
Macintosh.
Etc. Just a minute, we discussed three different environments. Suppose browsers, next programming languages, next
operating
environments, operating systems, otherwise you can say operating systems. Say browsers, programming languages, operating systems. Next, Selenium tool. Selenium IDE, Smita, Selenium IDE.
It supports only Firefox browser.
Selenium IDE, only Firefox. Only Firefox. Next, programming languages.
It doesn't support programming languages.
See, not applicable.
Not applicable.
Next, operating environments. Windows. Next.
Macintosh.
Linux. Mac, short form of Macintosh, etc. Next. Just a minute. Selenium RC, outdated RC. Various browsers. For example, Mozilla Firefox, Google Chrome, IE, Safari, Opera. Next, programming languages. Various programming languages.
Java.
Same.
Yes.
Selenium WebDriver. Various programming languages. Java, Perl, Python, Ruby, C Sharp. Next. Same. Operating environments or operating systems. This one. Next. Selenium WebDriver. Selenium WebDriver.
Same as RC.
Same as RC.
Yeah.
RC. Next, Selenium Grid. RT. Selenium Grid. See, first of all, Selenium Grid is not for test design. It's only for executing test cases in parallel. See, remaining tools, Selenium IDE, Selenium RC, Selenium WebDriver. for creating and executing test cases, but Selenium Grid only for executing test cases, not for creating test cases. But it supports various browsers to execute test cases. Next, what about various programming languages, Neeladri?
With all various programming languages.
Actually, this support is required for Selenium Grid. Here, no test case design.
Okay.
Here, no test case design, only execution. Okay.
Yeah.
It executes various programming, various test cases. Developed using various programming languages, but here actually not applicable. Selenium Grid is not for test case design, only for execution, but you can execute test cases written in Java or test case written in Python, etc. Next, operating environments.
All normal.
Same, just a minute. Same. Okay, now.
Sir, I have one question. The Selenium web driver is already doing everything. So why we need a Selenium Grid again, a different tool here?
The purpose is parallel test execution.
Oh, okay.
So we didn't discuss Selenium Grid now. Now we are in Selenium web driver. After web driver, I will explain Selenium Grid also. See, Selenium Grid, okay. Using Selenium IDE, you can execute Selenium IDE test cases. Using RC, you can execute RC test cases. Using WebDriver, you can execute WebDriver test cases. But why Selenium Grid? It is for executing test cases in parallel. Using multiple machines, you can execute test cases in parallel. Okay, na?
Got it, sir. Thank you.
Who is asking that question? Neeladri. Okay. See. Okay, now this table, Sanjida.
Yes.
Okay. Next, browser support, operating system support. Next, programming language support we discussed. Next, drawbacks of Selenium WebDriver. Drawbacks of Preeti. Contribute drawbacks of Selenium WebDriver.
No central repository.
Your answer is not correct, Preeti. In Selenium IDE, no centralized maintenance of objects or elements. No object repository concept. In Selenium IDE, no centralized maintenance or centralized maintenance of elements or objects. But in Selenium WebDriver, you can maintain elements in centralized location. That we will discuss later. Using page object model, POM, page object model. Using page object model, we can maintain elements in a centralized location in Selenium WebDriver. In Selenium IDE, no centralized maintenance. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Any other?
Yeah,
it doesn't generate data test reports.
Pardon? Generates?
It doesn't generate detailed test reports.
Okay. Yes. Next. Okay. Somebody trying to answer?
Sir.
Neeladri.
Like, It's Sunil here.
Ah. Tell me, Sunil.
The major drawback is there are no IDE here.
Yes, no IDE, only programming interface. So for yes. each and everything, we need to write programming. We need to write the code only. We need to write the
yes.
code. Ah, see. Selenium WebDriver. Selenium WebDriver has no IDE, no integrated development environment, only programming interface. Okay, then what is the problem? For each and everything, we need to write the code. So, creating test cases takes more time than other tools, Selenium IDE, EFT, etc. See, creating test cases in Selenium WebDriver takes more time than other tools. Why? For each and everything, we need to write the code. No tool features. Next, Preeti told, we can't generate detailed test reports. So here, no built-in result reporting facility. No built-in result reporting facility. For example, you take UFT, formerly QTP. UFT has a result reporting facility. For every test iteration, UFT provides test result in HTML format or XML format, and you can export that test result to documentation format also, MS Word. Say for every test iteration, means cycle of execution, UFT provides test result. But in Selenium WebDriver, no built-in result reporting facility. But no problem, we can overcome this drawback using TestNG annotations that we will discuss later. Next, takes more time to create test cases. To create test cases. Next, Selenium WebDriver doesn't have integrated spreadsheet for data-driven testing. It doesn't have an integrated spreadsheet for data-driven testing. No integrated spreadsheet in Selenium WebDriver. No problem. We can import external spreadsheet, Excel-like external spreadsheet, and conduct data-driven testing, but no integrated spreadsheet. For example, UFT, Unified Functional Testing, formerly QTP. UFT has Aarti. Can you remember? UFT has an integrated spreadsheet for data-driven testing, na?
Yeah, sir. Excellent stuff. Yes.
Okay. See, these are the important drawbacks of WebDriver. Tell me, Sanjida, what are the important drawbacks of Selenium WebDriver?
Selenium WebDriver doesn't have IDE. It's only the programming interface. And reporting, there is no reporting system.
No built-in reporting facility.
Yes.
No built-in.
And no built-in reporting facilities and no integrated spreadsheet.
Okay. Next, it takes more time for creating tests.
It takes more time, yeah.
Somebody trying to ask her, trying to ask me.
Yes, sir. This is Preeti. I didn't get the last part. It doesn't have an integrated spreadsheet. What does it mean?
Integrated spreadsheet means built-in Excel-like spreadsheet. If it is EFT tool, EFT has built-in sheet. You no need to import external file. You can open the data table and enter test data and connect. See, when it compares to UFT tool, UFT has built-in data table, Excel-like. You can use that built-in data table for data-driven testing. But in Selenium, no integrated spreadsheet means no built-in.
Okay.
No built-in spreadsheet. Okay. But you can import external file, na?
Yes, sir.
But in UFT tool, built-in spreadsheet is there. You can use that built-in file, built-in data table. Otherwise, you can import external file also. Okay.
Okay. Sir, one more question. Sir, when we are saying WebDriver doesn't create a detailed test report, in that case, if we are writing the test cases in WebDriver, so how we will generate the reports then?
What I told, no built-in result reporting facility, but you can report result using programming logic or using TestNG framework annotations, na? But no built-in feature, no built-in reporting facility. When it compares to UFT tool, UFT has built-in result report facility. If you execute any test case, then it will automatically generate detailed test report. That is built-in feature of UFT tool. But here no built-in feature. But you can adapt other you can adapt that feature from other resources. Hello?
Okay. Yes, sir.
No built-in feature. But no result reporting. I didn't say that one. No result reporting in Selenium WebDriver. Result reporting is there in Selenium WebDriver, but no built-in feature. Okay, na? We have to get support from other sources using programming logic or using TestNG or using JUnit, etc. Getting this point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, last one.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome. Last one, Selenium grid. See, actually you no need to use Selenium grid. If you want to execute tests in parallel, you use. What are the important features of Selenium grid? Selenium grid is used to execute tests across multiple browsers, operating environments, and machines in parallel. See, Selenium grid. The last 5 minutes. Selenium grid executes test cases across multiple browsers, multiple operating environments, and Machines means computers, systems, machines in parallel. Observe Sunil, suppose I have 100 test cases in my project. As per customer requirement or company strategy, I want to execute all these test cases using Mozilla Firefox, next Chrome and IE browsers. Suppose for executing all these 100 test cases, it takes 2 hours for Mozilla Firefox browser, approximately 2 hours for Chrome and 2 hours for IE browser. I want to execute 100 test cases using 3 different browsers. same 100 cases using Firefox, Chrome and IE browsers. For executing 100 cases, each browser is taking 2 hours. Total how many hours? Sunil.
It will be 6 hours.
6 hours. Suppose if we use Selenium grid, suppose I am using three machines and Selenium grid, you can distribute the execution process. Suppose on first mission, all 100 cases using Mozilla Firefox. On second mission, all these 100 cases, 100 test cases using Chrome browser. On third mission, using IE browser, all these test cases. Then it takes how many hours?
It's 2 hours.
2 hours. Yeah. See, by parallel test execution, we can reduce the test execution time. We can reduce the test execution time. Getting these points, Smita?
Yes, sir.
Next, Selenium grid supports Selenium RC tests as well as Selenium WebDriver tests. See, Selenium grid 2, not grid 1. Selenium grid 1 version supports only RC tests, but Selenium grid 2 supports Selenium RC remote control test cases and Selenium WebDriver test cases. But what about Selenium IDE? Gurunath, what about Selenium IDE?
It doesn't support, like, no, maybe it supports Selenium 1, supports.
No,
I don't. No, it doesn't.
Selenium grid doesn't support IDE tests. IDE tests in parallel.
Yes, sir.
Either RC or WebDriver.
WebDriver only.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
See, final conclusion. See, fourth topic, platform supported by Selenium, we will discuss tomorrow. Today you restrict to these three topics. What is Selenium? Next, Selenium's tool suite or Selenium components. And one more thing we discussed, small topic, history of Selenium project. Okay, last 1 or 2 minutes, you focus on just recommendation, suggestion. You focus on see, this is suggestion or recommendation. Java. Next, Selenium. Just a minute. Selenium WebDriver. Next, Java programming. Selenium WebDriver, Java programming, and TestNG framework. What is the purpose of TestNG framework? That we will discuss. That we will discuss later. See, TestNG framework, these three can be integrated. These three can be worked together. These three can be integrated. Selly, you focus on these three. One is Selenium WebDriver, another is Java programming, and third one is TestNG framework. You concentrate remaining features just briefly. You focus on these three only. Forget about remaining Selenium tools and other features. Okay. Selenium WebDriver. Sanjida Mukul, what is the purpose of Selenium WebDriver in our test automation?
Selenium test driver.
To create.
Speed up the automation.
Continue, Sunil.
Yeah, it's a programming interface to create and
execute test cases. Okay, using
element locators.
Element. Just a minute. Element locators. And web driver methods, or you can say commands. See, official site of Selenium, selenium.hq.org, in their documentation they used command term. Actually command is not suitable term, but SeleniumHQ.org, official site of Selenium, they used this term, Selenium command, but methods are commands. Okay, to create and execute test cases using element locators and web driver methods are commands. Okay, next, Java. What is the purpose of Java in our test automation?
To enhance test cases.
Good. Who is telling?
Smita.
Okay. Test automation. Java. To enhance test cases. What is enhancing test cases? Say, inserting verification points, adding comments, exception handling, parameterization, synchronization, etc. Pardon?
Does regular expression comes into
regular expression concept also? But important things are inserting verification points, adding comments, synchronization, parameterization, okay, etc. Next, TestNG framework. We didn't discuss this one. Just I will provide usage of TestNG framework. We have separate module for TestNG framework. To group test cases. Next. Execute test batches. and generate detailed test reports. Okay, you focus these three only. Last question for the day, Sunil. Focus on these three. Tell me, Selenium WebDriver, Selenium Java, TestNG. What is the purpose of Selenium WebDriver?
To create and execute the test cases using the element locators
and the WebDriver methods or commands.
WebDriver methods and commands.
What is the purpose of Java programming in this scenario?
To enhance the test cases.
Next, TestNG framework. To group test cases, grouping test cases, executing test cases, and generating detailed test reports. Okay, na?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Okay, all of you, I'm going to close the session. Any queries? Gurunath, Neeladri, any queries regarding this session?
No, I don't have any queries, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Welcome.
I have a question, sir.
Ask me. Who is telling? Who is asking?
Neeladri.
Neeladri, ask me.
Yes, just curious. After end of this course, can we able to make framework?
We discuss the TestNG framework.
Yeah, so at the end of this course, we can able to make a Selenium framework?
Yes, Selenium framework, you can use either JUnit or TestNG, if it is Java, those are the only frameworks. If it is Java, we use TestNG or JUnit. TestNG is advanced framework. We discuss TestNG framework in our training program. Suppose if we use C#, then NUnit, different frameworks. Yes, we discuss framework concept in our training program. And one more thing, after our program, you definitely start project test automation using Selenium.
Okay, that's great.
Welcome. Any queries? Sunil, I'm going to close the session.
Okay, sir.
Smita. Sanjita.
I have a question. Yes, sir. Are you providing any certifications?
Don't ask that type of questions. Only regarding this class, subject related. If you want to ask any other questions, you just mail me. I will send the details or I will send answer. Okay.
Okay.
Only subject related. Only today's class related to today's class. Any queries? Sanjida, any queries?
No queries. I'm good.
We'll meet tomorrow, same time. Thank you.